My great-grandpa probably was forward-thinking in some things. He was one of the first farmers in this area to work with the Extension Service to determine what an agronomic rate is for manure, like how much manure to put on for each crop, because they don't all need the same amount of nitrogen. That's a tradition I think we're proud of, that we get to keep working towards understanding things better and doing a better job.
So in 1950, that was about the time when we had most dairy cows in the United States. We had about 25 million dairy cows. And since then, we have gone down from 25 million to now 9 million dairy cows. But with this much smaller herd today, we are producing 60% more milk. And that means that over the last 70 years, we have dropped the carbon footprint of a glass of milk by 2/3. Our cows are much more capable today of utilizing nutrients in a most effective way. So the genetic merit has improved drastically. That's number one. Number two is we have a veterinary system today that helps us to either prevent diseases or treat diseases. The third one is reproductive efficiency. If you can't get a cow pregnant, you will not have milk. So obviously a very important factor. And then last but not least, we have optimized the feeding.
At Sunny Dean, we think of dairy farming as a land-based or plant-based food production system, even though when you say the word dairy, you think of the cow. For us, it is a combination of the plants and the land and the cow that make it work for us. As we've improved our understanding of how plants feed cattle, how cattle use that plant tissue to create nutrients for human food, and to waste as little of those nutrients as possible in the way of gas emissions.
Here in California, a couple years ago, the legislature passed a law called SB 1383. This law mandates a 40% reduction of methane, 40% reduction of methane, to be achieved in just a few years by the year 2030. Our dairymen went wild when they heard that, thinking, oh my gosh, how in the world can we achieve that reduction? But the legislature did something wise. The state funded $500 million to assist our dairy and other industries to reducing methane. And what shall I tell you? We have had dozens of anaerobic digesters and so-called alternative manure management practices established. And those practices have already, and we are just a few years in now, already reduced the carbon footprint of our dairy sector by 25%. That's remarkable.
The big farms are able to use it right now because they have that critical mass or scale or whatever to kind of prove those technologies. Until it's proved on a big farm, we can't really bring it here. You know, we just don't know if it's going to work. And so I might be farther down the line in adopting that kind of stuff, but it's nice to be able to say it has proven itself on another farm. It works. We can do it. I would love to be able to bring something like that onto the farm. You know, I live here. My kids live here. We drink this water. We breathe this air. This place means more to me, you know, than almost anything. It's my home. It's been our home for four generations.